We are going to do that, but first we are going to do two more puzzles. One's up there and one's in here. We'll do the one up here first because I actually know what I'm doing. Probably going to have to have a quick look online for the other one instead of working it out for myself.
10 people. A small wedding. But moving country means making a new life and new friends.
Every town has its own mayday celebration, but many people travelled from around the British Isles for the annual Pinwheel Maypole Morris Dancing Competition. Such a beautiful English tradition, and a rare thing these days.
Don't play sugar in fridge. No. I like that advice. I think it's good advice. Mayday preparations. Simon Shorrocks, make sure you tidy and clean all of the upstairs bedrooms before I return from town. I need them spotless, as we have Grandpa Joe coming to stay with us for the Mayday festivities. Georgina, can you please clean up all the pots in the kitchen as well as mop the floor? We'll be cooking for many tonight, and I want to cook hassle-free. Benjamin, can you sweep the hallway and ensure all windows are open to let the house ventilate? There is a foul smell coming from somewhere in here, and I bet it's one of you three. We will be staying in the master bedroom tonight together. I know it's cramped, but we all have to make sacrifices for the comfort of others in this situation. Also ensure that you let me know of anything missing from your equipment. I'll need to order anything through the post office soon. Please don't let me down. Mum. Kiss. Oh, and a stamp, which we need in a second. There we go. Right, so this is, I believe we're using this to order Morris dancing equipment that we need, that we're missing. We'll find out what that is in a minute when we go upstairs. I just want to have a look in here. Not that I think there's anything really in here. Oh, there's a note here. Hey, borrowed a stamp. Don't forget to post the order for your Mayday ankle bells. Kiss, kiss. Nope, don't think there's anything else. So that's where we'll place the order, but we don't actually know what it's called yet. Okay, so this is the book for the Grumpy Knocker, which doesn't actually do anything, but I sort of want it.
Okay, Restorer, it's time to venture into our first core memory. I can't contact you when you're inside, so good luck. When you're ready, activate the music box and step through the doorway.
Not quite yet, Phyllis. I'll do that in a bit, and then I'll stop recording. So that I don't go mad from playing this puzzle game, because my brain will ache for a while afterwards. I don't think there's anything in here. It doesn't look like it. It's a recorder, shoe. Right, in here. Mum, do you know where my Mayday equipment is? I can't find it anywhere. I always forget the actual names of the Mayday stuff, so it's so old-sounding. Here is the stuff I need. One hat, two bells, one stick. I think that's all. Thanks. So, this puzzle I didn't actually manage to do last time, because I'm an idiot, for one. But also because I broke the puzzle. So, last time I picked up one of these ankle bells, and I put them down on there, and then it just didn't work at all, okay? So the point of this is that we need to know the proper name for the ankle bells so that we can put it on the letter to post it off for it. To do that, you have to hover over it and use the left mouse button, and they're called baldricks. They're not. I don't even think they are actually called baldricks, because last time I did this puzzle, I forgot that you could do that. I forgot that mechanic. So I looked it up on Google instead, and I don't think they're actually called Baldrix. Baldrix is something else in Morris Dancing. But anyway, Baldrix is what we need for this puzzle. Don't pick them up or the hat up or anything, because you can't put them back down and you'll just break the puzzle and you won't be able to do it. Strong advice coming from experience. Item name. Baldrix. Quantity. Don't really need to know that. One.
All the invitations beautifully handwritten and sealed.
So, and then...
We would be delighted if you could attend our special day. Please RSVP.
We have to take this over to the post office. Put it in the post box.
Let's hope everyone can make it.
And then in here, there will now be a package with some Baldrix / just bells in it. Which we take up to here. Get through the damn door. Put it here. Well, possibly. I think we can... Yes!
Every single invitation applied to. And with the same answer. Yes.
So with that one, you can put it back down there.
We've received an email today from the Board of Directors. It seems that I'm going to have to submit a report on my findings and treatment progress so far. Funding really is the last thing I need to worry about right now. Anyway, I used the engagement ring a couple hours ago, and my patient is still smiling from ear to ear. I really feel like there's a huge well of emotion trapped away inside, and if I could just find the right item to release it, then this will all be of value. I think I may be able to use this patient as a case study. An example of how effective this treatment really is.
So, we have the engagement ring and projection reel. Right, let's head out of here. I'm really sorry that
the
subtitles...
Time for the real celebration to begin.
The subtitles sometimes don't work on this game, which can be a little frustrating, but sometimes they don't. So, Alexander Bell Workshop.
It glistened in the shop window. A music box with the most beautiful decoration.
A great man once worked here. Part philosopher, part engineer. His radical new ideas changed the course of history forever. Let's find out what this has to do with anything.
Yes, let's do that, Phyllis. So, there's a note up here. Failures. More damn failures plague my work. Equipment has been breaking all of the time, forcing me to buy in bulk or to search out expensive and specific parts. The Hemingways, who run the post office, must think I'm creating Frankenstein. Sometimes I wonder if I am, especially with so many failed attempts. It's like God is stopping me in my tracks, preventing me from creating this wondrous machine for some unfathomable reason. How can more conversation and contact be a bad thing? A. Bell. End. No, sorry. Couldn't resist. No. So, this sign up here says, when one door closes, another opens, but we often look so long and so regretfully upon the closed door that we do not see the one which is opened. That sign. Right. You can't get through here. None of the keys work on it. I looked at that sign and read it like 5 times before I actually figured out, not even on my own, just by looking at a walkthrough, that you have to close this door.
The opening and closing the delicate lid to hear what was inside was just too tempting.
Sometimes when you're doing something yourself, you just cannot see what you're doing wrong, but as soon as you watch someone else doing it, then you can. It's very odd. thing about humans. Sound. I stand and look out of my window at the top of my stairs, overlooking the lighthouse and the buoys that bob away in the harbour. I feel like I am at my most content and thoughtful. The sound in the distance inspired me to explore different tones with the machine. When I stand here and simply watch, I feel I am close, unfathomably close to that great discovery, a bell. And we have a hammer for hitting bells with. So this has to do with the boys over there. I'm not entirely sure what yet. Oh god, okay, right. Put that down there. There's nothing in that drawer. Tenancy agreement. Dear Mr. Bell, thank you for bringing back the tenancy agreement. Your 6-month lease will start next Monday, but feel free to move in whenever suits you best. I know it's only a small space, but it's close to the workshop and you get a nice view of the harbour. Also, it's quite handy for electricity if you still want to run cables down to the workshop basement. That is Mechanical Engineering by A. Bell, which I do not need. Paper. Pinwall Post, May 15th, 1966. Communal funeral held for miners lost. Funeral procession for the 23 fallen workers of Brinkliff Mine was received by the entire village. Some stood silently while others clapped as the procession passed by. Many showed tears of care and love for the brave men, and plenty placed flowers on their coffins. The fallen miners were all drowned when an unscheduled explosion trapped them in a chamber that flooded with seawater from the English Channel. Hundreds of residents from the surrounding villages and towns began to gather at around 9 a.m. BST in preparation for the procession. As you can tell, after a while, I simply cannot read. I'm going to take that, because I don't know if or when I'll need it. And there's a secret bit under here. Just take the hammer and put it back in here for a second until we can use it. Get that out. Now, the code for this I think we found earlier in his actual home. So it's 0427. There we go. Oh, and another grumpy knocker.
He eats your skin and leaves nothing but your bones, Andrew said with a sinister tone in his voice. That's rubbish, said Rob, sounding a little unsure of himself. Dad works in the mine every day, and he's never said nothing. Oh, no? Asked Andrew. Why don't we go see for ourselves, then? If you're so sure. 'Cause we'll get grounded. Mom said we're not allowed at the docks, even when it's daylight. No, you're not allowed at the docks. I'm the oldest, and I'm saying it's okay. We just won't tell anyone. I don't know, Andy, said Rob. Well, I do. Get your coats. We're going now.
Well, if that doesn't sound like a bad idea, I don't know what does, boys. Put them down there. And take the hammer. This is the bit that I have no clue about. This projector is one part restored, and I don't know how to do the rest of it. So essentially what you've got to do is... Right. So essentially it's one on the left one on the middle one, another one on the left one, and one on the far right, I think. And if I've worked that out properly, then I'm happy, because that would be a great step in puzzle games for me. Even though I had to get a walkthrough to point out that it was something to do with the boys, I think I knew that before, I just couldn't be bothered to go and look and work it out, because I thought it would be more complicated than that. So I think it's... sound here with the hammer.
It took 5 months and 2 lots of pocket money to buy such a beautiful music box. Only fair that it should spend a little time in each person's house. Memories. Beautiful memories are made of beautiful things. This is one of them.
Okay, so the item I'm beginning with is the music box. The diary entry suggests that this was an early memory, and I think this may trigger a strong emotional response if I use it at the right time. It may be too early to tell, but looking at what I have, I think this may be the strongest item here, due to the fact that there's a musical element attached to it. Which